front of one of the great archaeological discoveries of our time, the mysterious Temple of the Forbidden Eye. Hello, I'm Michael Eisner, head of the Walt Disney Company. In an unprecedented move, the Walt Disney Imagineers have brought, piece by piece, this incredible treasure to America. You can now tour the Temple of the Forbidden Eye at Disneyland in Anaheim, California. But first, a warning. If you choose to explore the temple, be aware that some say an evil and treacherous curse hangs over this ancient building. Enter at your own risk, and I'm out of here.
The making of Disneyland's Indiana Jones Adventure. Starring Karen Allen and John Rhys-Davies.
Karen, come immediately. Must show you Jewel of the Jungle. Rich treasure. Archaeological marvel. Indy still deep in temple. Take fast ship and meet me earliest possible date. John.
Temple of the Forbidden Eye.
Eye on the Globe. Deadline India. Fiction becomes fact as the mysterious subcontinent reveals a legendary treasure. After 2,000 years, the lost Temple of the Forbidden Eye has been unearthed by famed archaeologist Dr. Henry Indiana Jones. Scholarly research laid the groundwork for Dr. Jones' discovery. But in the end, a secret map and a healthy helping of bravery led him to the temple door. Teaming with noted Egyptian archaeologist Sama, Dr. Jones summoned the courage to go where no man had set foot for two millennia. His tenacity paid off. The Forbidden Eye was open for all who dared enter. Legend was the temple god Mara could bestow the gifts of wealth, youth, or future knowledge on those pilgrims who were worthy. Thus, the jungles of India became the destination for adventurers worldwide. And what a destination it is! Until recently, dozens of curious globetrotters climbed these ancient steps, seeking enrichment and fame. For some, just hobnobbing with the well-to-do was the treat of a lifetime. But rumor of a treacherous curse now hangs over the temple, and some even whisper that visitors have been disappearing forever behind the silent temple walls. So far, even Dr. Jones hasn't been able to confirm or deny it. Until he does, the Temple of the Forbidden Eye will remain off-limits to all but the most foolhardy. It doesn't take a college degree to know that some riches, no matter how grand, aren't worth their deadly price. Until next week, this is Eye on the Globe.
Hello? Anybody here?
Your Disneyland passport.
John, I didn't travel all this way to end up like Smiling Jack there. Don't just sit there with your mouths open. We're at the Indiana Jones Adventure.
In Anaheim, California. Welcome. Karen, I have to send you. The Disneyland Imagineers have recreated the entire temple complex down to its last deadly detail. If you come with me, I will show you magnificent murals. I will show you dark secrets carved into the stone. I will show you rooms filled to the ceilings with treasures.
Treasures? Okay, Hotshot. I'm game.
Stick close. Here you see work in progress on the rotunda. Miss Bonds, may we have a look at the map?
You might guess.
Are these Indy's sketches?
Oh, yes. Yes, indeed. Yes, he made these when he made this fantastic discovery. See, there are miles and miles of passageways and hidden vaults and treasure. This is a find of major significance. And danger.
Danger? Isn't this some sort of ride or something?
Well, that's of course why it's been rebuilt here in Disneyland, but Karen, the problem is they have reconstructed it so exactly that they have imported the original curse.
Curse?
Curse. Ask him, he's worked here forever.
There is one warning.
Never.
Never look into the eyes of Mara.
Mara, the god of the temple? In every mural I've ever seen, Mara's eyes are always closed.
Not always. Come. Mr. Lang, the projector.
Extraordinary. I'm glad to have gotten through it alive.
Amazing. It's just amazing. I love it. It's so much fun.
Now my heart's beating and I'm an old man, so I love them.
For some mom, your spiders here.
So much fun.
Oh, it's great.
It's the most amazing thing I've ever been on. Yeah, it's surreal.
George Lucas worked with us on this project, and he got very much involved with the fact that we were trying to put you in one of his films. We were trying to put you in the movie and make it like Indiana Jones adventure, three-dimensional.
There's a lot of very, very exciting elements from the movies that are actually in the ride, but they're very real. This is a real event.
Of course, it's very believable as you're going down into this creepy temple, kind of winding through the corridors, that you're going to run into the same things that Indiana Jones runs into.
So, where's Indy?
Oh, he's in there somewhere, you know him, beavering away.
Here, you're going to cause things to happen. And I think that that part of it, bringing that action-adventure thrill to life for guests, where they can actually play the part of Indiana Jones, is going to be different. You're not watching a movie being made, but you are living the movie. The marriage of a sophisticated new ride technology with the Indiana Jones mythology is something that we were all interested in. And I think here at the Temple of the Forbidden Eye, we've presented a chance to find the secret to this temple god Mara's power and possibly have a chance to get one of these three magical gifts.
As I told you before, the temple offers one of three great gifts: knowledge of future events, immense wealth, or the secret of eternal youth. Consider which one you choose.
Walt once said something that I've taken to heart. He said, if I didn't create a believable environment, then no one would believe the magic when they get down to that point in the show.
The team got very, very excited about this attraction. Everybody really got involved in it, and people would go out and bring in their old National Geographics from the 30s that would look at things and see, oh, that's what the temples look like in India and Cambodia and things like that, so that we really themed this as accurately as possible.
I think half of the sensory input that comes to you about the authenticity and the believability is in the actual aging of it, to make it look like something that you believe had been exposed to humidity, moisture, heat. Almost half of the difficulty and the work that has gone into this is not only coming up with amazing things that are totally believable, but then finding a way that no one can see how we did it.
The thing that makes the Indiana Jones adventure bigger and better than anything that's ever been done is the ride technology. In the case of effects like real fire or explosions, these obviously have to be something that makes a big impression on you, but it also can play every 18 seconds.
In Indy, every 18 seconds, everybody's getting a different experience. So we had to combine the safety aspects of a very controllable adventure with something that feels out of control, because that's the whole point of it. Indy was a reckless kind of adventurer, and the vehicle had to be something capable of delivering a reckless performance.
We've given the show producer the ability to program in a personality for each vehicle. So each vehicle has its own personality. And if you watch the vehicle in front of you go through the ride, that doesn't necessarily mean you'll follow the same path or have the same experience.
This is the first time on a Disney ride that the vehicles actually look old. They're scratched up, they're beat up, they're rusted. And as they age, they will look even better. Even though they look old, they are state of the art.
First, let's tell you about some of the passenger amenities. There's 12 seats with extra long seat belts, so we can hold any size passenger. There's 24 speakers on the vehicle, two for each guest.
Front wheel drive.
High beams and low beams.
20 feet per second, maximum speed.
This vehicle is a rubber tired vehicle, and it rides on these rubber tires.
If you had a large extension cord, you could drive this vehicle to your local McDonald's.
And even though you're at Disneyland, there's times that I think you'll go, wait a minute, there's something wrong. Something's going wrong on this. This shouldn't be doing this, because we're that close to really making you feel like you're completely out of control and something's gone wrong.
In recreating this temple here, we have inscribed all of the codes concerning the temple god Mara and recreated in exact detail all the warning pieces of the temple. And since we put all of those in place, there's been a lot of strange things that have been happening. So we don't know for sure, but there could be a lot of credibility to this curse.
And we'll notice strange things sometimes in the deep corners in the dark, and it gets a little spooky here at night sometimes.
And most importantly, never, ever look into the eyes of Mara, because if you do, it's all over.
There's nothing like that on the planet.
All right, are you prepared to face unspeakable terrors, repulsive reptiles, temple syndrome, lots of squishy creatures, and or loud noises in order to confront Mara face to face?
Sure.
How about snakes?
Snakes. Okay. How close will they be?
Close.
Not too many. Hope you don't have a thing about snakes.
Wait one moment. Yes, you are over 48 inches tall. You are cleared for embarkation. Military-style transportation will take you to the heart of the temple. There you will be close to the real power of Mara.
What about you?
Me?
You're not coming?
Well no, I've got too many things.
I don't know about this.
When I do anything, you put your life in danger. You know, this truck's been missing for about a month.
You never mentioned anything about skeletons.
Didn't I?
No, you didn't. Has anybody ever come back from this adventure in one piece?
Of course they have. I mean, there was a guy only last month who made it.
One?
It's a new ride, Karen. There are bound to be one or two things that are going to be ironed out.
Thank you, John, but I think I will just come back some other time.
Karen!
You don't have to deal with your snake.
Karen. Now, we are so close. Karen, you stand on the brink of enlightenment.
I stand on my way out the door. It's nice to see you again, John.
Sweetheart, if you just knew what Disney's Imagineers have done to make this ride, you'd be dying to ride it.
To turn a phrase. No.
Not to mention the free gifts.
Gifts?
I mean major class one gifts.
You missed something.
Oh. Copy. Now, just fasten your seatbelt, and you'll be ready to go. Good luck.
Hey, wait a minute, Buster.
Wait,
I'm not going alone.
Wait, no, Karen, no. Oh, Karen, I'll do it. I have
it. Use your knowledge. Let's give that a whirl.
Boy, man, what have I got down there?
Come on.
Let me get this truck out.